Hey guys, hope everybody's having a great week. Last week we talked about self-confidence, and so this week we're going to talk about the two things that give us that self-confidence and that would set those that are elite apart from those that aren't. Two things. Number one, creating experiences that give us that self-confidence. Number two is trusting the training. Okay, so number one, when you're in elementary school, junior high school, whatever, you have either made up your mind by the time you get to high school that you're either bad at math or you're good at math. Why? Past experiences. Okay. So our past experiences in taking a math test, whether you were good at it, you weren't good at it, whatever, has led you to believe that you are either good in something or bad in something. Does that make sense? That same principle can be applied to rodeo and the past experiences that we have at certain rodeos or with certain calves or on certain horses or whatever is going to shape our self-confidence and lead us to believe that we're either able to do this or we're not. So the reason that the guys that make the NFR every year stay at an elite level is because they have built up enough positive past experiences to get them through any kind of slump that they might have. They know that they deserve to be there, why? Because look at their past experiences, whether it's NFR qualifications, whether it's world championship buckles, they can look back at their past experiences subconsciously, and that keeps their self-confidence at a high. Make sense? Okay, so creating past experiences. One thing that works for me is visualization workbooks. I write down my visualizations. I start in the chute, whatever it might be for you. Write out those visualizations, and I try to do that on a regular basis. And all I'm doing is creating, subconsciously, mentally, creating past experiences that are going to help me in the future. Does that make sense? Okay, so I'm sorry to extend it. One more week. Next week, we'll talk about trusting the training and how that's going to help you build self-confidence. But for this week, think about how can I shape my past experiences to boost my self-confidence. Have a great week. See you guys later.